quand on sait que pour la plupart des espèces animales
for most animal and plant species, room is necessary for them to live in, and at the same time they must be in connection. If you look at this lawn, obviously here biodiversity is very poor because there are very few species. We're going to have a look at the factors that impact the quality of biodiversity in town. First of all, regional factors, climate conditions. Biodiversity is not the same in a tropical town as in a temperate town. The quality of air, water and soil also influences biodiversity. And finally, the peri-urban space quality has an influence when the town is surrounded by forest or by intensive agricultural land. This is also going to impact biodiversity. Soil land occupancy before the town was built is also important. Some towns were built in areas where biodiversity was rich, near rivers or very near areas that were cultivated to feed the town dwellers. These towns will benefit from more biodiversity compared with places, towns built in poor biodiversity areas. We see this picture that an area dedicated to agriculture was turned into an urban area, but here we see that there was very little biodiversity and therefore the buildings benefited from a very low biodiversity after they were being built. Now, here we have to consider diversity and complementarity with green spaces. There are parks with ornamental flowers, waste land, garden, vegetable gardens, and lawns around buildings. And the quality of the green areas determines the biodiversity in town. In order to quantify biodiversity in town, we have developed an index of flora interest. This index is calculated from four parameters: the wealth, the number of species found in a given habitat, how specialized these species are in a given environment versus generalistic species that can grow just about anywhere, naturality, whether the species are local rather than exotic, which may sometimes be rather invasive, and the rarity of these species. And all of these characteristics will determine the quality of the green space, the green area. The index is close to zero in poor spaces. Here we see grass growing between the cobblestones in a yard, and close to one when we are in a natural sort of area with more interesting species growing. Green areas were observed and analyzed in the Hauts-de-Seine area close to Paris, and we assessed the spaces depending on the quality of the flora. Very anthropic environments, intermediary environments or subnatural environments are very different. And the green areas that are more natural are the ones benefiting from the most interesting biodiversity, whereas the bottom of walls or cracks in the tarmac sort of environment obviously have the poorest biodiversity and only very banal species will grow. Regarding other species, such as bats, we find more bats in areas where there are suburban gardens or residential areas rather than in industrial areas which are very urbanized. Similarly, the quality of habitats found in those spaces, for instance, the quality of the hedges, has a strong impact on the presence of bats and the number of bats. When the hedges are mixed or made of deciduous trees, there are more bats than in places where the hedges are made of conifers. Age and the density of urbanization have an impact on biodiversity in town and the quality thereof. Here we have a town center with very few plant species, as opposed to a more recent type of building with more green spaces, and obviously biodiversity will be greater on the right-hand side picture. Now, also the area, the total area of green spaces is very important. Here the curve shows that how many species of birds can be found in green spaces, and obviously in the largest areas there is the greater number of species. Finally, there are connections between those green spaces, which influences the quality of biodiversity. In a town, the distance between the gardens and the green spaces must not be too long so that they can exchange species and animals. And permeability between of the area around the green areas or gardens must also be sufficiently permeable for the species to travel. For instance, the streets must be organized in a given way, there must be green walls and green roofs and as few obstacles as possible. Hedges, walls and fences around gardens should be avoided. But the most important factor is the way the green spaces are managed. Sometimes they are managed in a very drastic way, or on the contrary, they might be managed in a far softer way. And obviously, when they are managed in a softer way, biodiversity is best. Here we have the wealth of plants found in lawns which are managed with herbicides or pesticides offer less species, less biodiversity versus lawns where no phytosanitary pesticides are used. The number of times a lawn is mown also influences the quality of biodiversity. When the lawn is mown twice a year, maybe the number of species will be far greater than in the lawns which are being mown once a week or once a month. Now, if we look at the quality of the species growing in the lawns, we find rare species in the lawns which are not treated with pesticides, and also rare species in lawns that are not trodden over by town dwellers. The fact that lawns are managed in a certain way will have an incidence on the quality of biodiversity. Look at the diversity of butterflies. We have two maps regarding the Parisian area, Paris and the suburbs. We see that the area is highly urbanized with many, many buildings, everything in red. And the wealth in butterflies is the opposite picture. Obviously, there are more butterflies where there are less buildings. The number of species of butterflies found in gardens depends very much on the type of garden. Here we have the data from this participative program where the garden owners sent us data regarding the type of butterflies and the number of butterflies they could observe in their gardens. They described the gardens, and the more there are natural areas which are not mown and where no pesticides are used, the greater the number of butterflies, and the people can observe more butterflies and report them. Also, if ornamental flowers producing nectar are planted and cultivated, there are more butterflies present in the garden. So the type of garden and the way it's managed will influence the number of butterflies visiting the garden, and this is true even in highly urbanized towns. Recommendations in order to improve biodiversity quality in town. Room should be made available for large green spaces, well diversified, but connected between them by corridors such as lawn-covered corridors, tree bottoms or hedges. Small green spaces must be multiplied throughout town. These spaces must be managed in a very soft way, and pesticides and chemicals must be totally ruled out. And this will be the case very soon, because the use of pesticides and phytosanitary products in public spaces will be banned within a couple of years. This is already the case in some towns in France, in order to improve town dwellers' well-being and in order to improve biodiversity.